worry about Becky, Zach. She's where the oil can't hurt her now.
Oil.
Faster than you can say Texas tea, the gang bonds together to put that evil oil tycoon back in his place.
Cal Star and the school board will be partners in building a beautiful new Bayside. It will cost you nothing.
Yes, but will it bring back Becky?
Will it bring back Becky?
That's not true.
What do you mean, young man?
Yes, you, the lone hero in the back.
Where are the oak trees behind the library?
Well, I'm afraid we'll have to replace them.
No, you mean cut them down and put up an oil derrick. Like this? Oh. Yes, but what happens if there's a bigger accident and oil gets over everything just like this?
Oh, and this is outrageous!
Oh, this is most unorthodox!
We don't want to go to school in an oil field.
We already have a better Bayside. We just didn't know it until now.
You duck-killing motherfucker!
That's right, kids. Just remember, oil is evil. I mean, what the hell do we need oil for anyway? Oh yeah, to run our cars. But there's tons of other natural energy resources to run our cars, like solar, which is practically non-existent. So there's hybrid, which is far too expensive for anyone to afford. But there's electric, which is still in the developing stages. So for the time being, I guess we're stuck with oil. Evil, nasty oil! It kills ducks. Another episode I'm sure you all remember is the drug episode, where Jessie gets addicted to caffeine pills because she wants to pass geometry and do well in her new girl rock group. Wait. A girl rock group? How the hell did that come along? Well, it turns out Zach really thought the three girls had potential, so Screech dresses up as a female Irish janitor and records them singing in the girls' locker room. Finally, something realistic. I remember when I dressed up like a female Irish janitor and recorded things in the girls' locker room. Why don't you just forget I said that?
Next time, bring me.
So the recording is given to a record producer, who of course loves it, and the three girls decide to put together a music video for them. Oh God, help me. This is back when music videos didn't know they were insulting our intelligence, and also when they were, you know, popular. Say what you will about this song, but these special effects are just incredible. Like, watch this unbelievable stunt. Oh my God, how did they do that? There was one person there, and then suddenly there's another. Is this that mystical voodoo they talk about called a jump cut? Also, get a load of this.
Their faces are dissolving over the picture! Witchcraft!
Feeling the pressure, Jessie continues to take her caffeine pills and becomes... mildly annoying.
We'll be great, we'll be awesome, we'll knock him down, right? Yeah!
Oh yes, I forgot to mention the popular music sting, which is played just before every commercial break. The weird thing is that the music is so bland that you never know if it's positive or negative until you hear the subject matter.
Guys, we struck oil.
Guys, there's been an oil spill! There's oil everywhere!
This music's so vague you can put it to anything. Hey everybody, Kelly's top just fell off! Oh no, Lisa is pregnant with Screech's baby! Wow, Zach just saved a puppy right after his mother died! You see? The big scene everyone remembers is near the end when she has her giant breakdown in front of Zach.
I just need one of these.
Pills? You mean you really are taking drugs?
I need them.
Jessie, give me those.
I need them, Zach! I have to sing!
Jessie!
I'm so excited! I'm so excited! I'm so... scared!
Wow. Wow. I had no idea that caffeine pills could turn you into such a horrible actor. Well, I'm getting rid of these babies right now! Good old-fashioned mescaline for me. Oh, God, that soothes.
Finally, I want to talk about one more episode. This is my personal favorite. It's called Rockumentary, and it's this strange kind of behind-the-music look at the kids after they make it big as a rock band. You heard right, they make it big as a rock band. Just look at some of the clothes they wear. It's like the 80s are trying to die, but someone keeps trying to resuscitate them. Just let the decade die in peace. Look at this. When the hell did anyone wear bows on their jeans? Are you a fucking birthday present? But I digress. This odd little music documentary is hosted by Casey Kasem, of all people, as he apparently has mastered the power of time travel to show you how their story began. Apparently, the group practiced in their garage playing their instruments and lip-syncing rather horribly. Just look at Slater's drum work. He plays so well that the beats come out before he even taps them.
Little did they know that fate was running by their door.
Yeah, was there a record producer named Brian Fate who happened to be jogging past the garage?
Hello, I'm Brian Fate.
Alright, it's a little funny. He, of course, turns them into rock legends, as they do concerts, sign autographs, get awards from bad impersonators. It's a dream come true. Now, one thing you might be asking yourself is, where's Jessie in all of this? Well, they saw how she did with the last rock group she signed up with, and, yeah, they're not doing that again. So of course, as their popularity builds, a seductive PR woman steps in and seduces Zach to leave the group and go solo. Letting the fame go to his head, Zach agrees with Yoko Ono and leaves the group to go do his own thing, as she controls everything about him, even the way he looks. Alright, now, I have to warn you. This next scene, where Zach shows himself in his brand new look, is one of the funniest things ever put on television. It will cause laughter beyond your control. Just remember to breathe, inhale, and exhale. This has been known to kill people. People have actually died from laughter. I just want you to keep that in mind before you watch this. Take a deep breath. All right, let's watch the scene.
No problem, they love you. They absolutely love me.
So, if you survive that, Zach eventually gets back together with his group and goes on to make music history. And then, of course, he wakes up because it was all obviously a dream. Thank God, because if I looked like MC Hammer and Prince's White Love Child, I would want it to be a dream too.
You know, next year I'm asking for weekdays off.
So that's Saved by the Bell. How does it hold up? It doesn't. It's stupid, silly, and loaded with idiotic cliches. But I will say that looking back on it, it is pretty harmless. I mean, I don't think it makes kids any dumber like some of the other shows I've reviewed on here. But if I was to sum up this show in one word, I would say that it's...
dumb.
Stupid.
Crazy. Dangerous.
Stinks.
And then some. I'm the Nostalgia Critic, I remember it, so you don't have to.